In the land of Mordor, in the fires of Mount Doom, the Dark Lord Sauron forged in secret a master dife to control all others. And into the dife he poured his cruelty, his malice, and his will to dominate all life. One dife to rule them all.
From the Andrew Groovy Mains production team studios in a very sunny the Netherlands, I'm Mixmaster G and welcome to this tutorial. I hope you liked the intro. It was a suggestion made by one of the DGA conversion utility users who came up with the phrase one drive to rule them all. I'm not a particular Lord of the Ring fans. For me, there's only one return and it ain't the king. For all those who like Lord of the Rings, this was for you folks. What we are going to do in this tutorial is we are going to convert a standard CDG USB drive, one you plug into a CDG and is prepared by Rekordbox, into a drive that will work with Serato, with Traktor and with the Denon Prime players, maintaining all cues, loops, playlists, crates, etc., etc., and your BPM value, and the latter one is very important for those Prime player users. Let me first show you what we are going to work with. Right here, there is a Nexus 2, and it got the USB inserted. We are going to convert to one that works with everything. So let's eject that USB stick. And it's right here. It's, as you can see, your default SanDisk drive. And I can recommend these USB to all you folks. They are blazingly fast, especially if you use the Sync Manager in Rekordbox. And they work very, very well with all platforms. And as you can see, the drive is right here. This is the drive. And let's fire up Rekordbox, because the first line of business we are going to do is I have to create a Rekordbox XML out of this drive. And in order to do that, I use a separate macOS account where my Rekordbox collection is entirely empty. If you don't know how to create a separate macOS account, go to the link right above me and that will show you how to do it and how to prepare it for Pioneer XML creation out of a CDG USB. You can see right here my demo USB, and if I left click the playlists and say import folder, it will import the folder. This phase is very important. Click the do not copy. We don't want to copy the tracks from the USB into the computer. We want to keep the tracks on the USB. Now there is a bug in Rekordbox which not always takes all the cues and loops with it. So I have to double check, and you see there are no cues and loops right here. In order to fix that, just click the device, right click it again and say update collection. Takes a few moments and after that we will see that the cues and loops are there. That means this is all good to go. I export the collection in XML format, and for easy reference I put it on the USB and I name it USB. That's all I need to do in Rekordbox, again in a clean macOS account. The next phase is firing up the DJ conversion utility. And we tell it we want to go from a Rekordbox XML. Now we have to specify the source, and the source is on the CDG USB, the USB XML which was just created. I say that I want to go to Serato and that I want to go to Traktor, and additionally I'm going to enable the iTunes integration. As you can see, the iTunes collection is empty as well. But what is important are the iTunes preferences. Under the Advanced tab, make sure that the Keep the iTunes Media folder organized is off and the Copy Files to the iTunes Media folder is off. And if you are on iTunes 12, you need to enable the Share the XML file with other apps. This is iTunes 11 I'm using on a Mojave machine because I like iTunes 11 more than I like 12. But that's just a personal preference. This is the important one. Under the advanced preferences, make sure those two are off and the XML export is on. That means the DJ conversion utility is good to go. And it asks me if I want to control iTunes. Again, these are the famous Mojave pop-ups that keep popping up and protect you from any harm. This is a DJ conversion utility warning, which tells me that there are going to be tags written to the track media files. And that's a very important warning. We take the imported playlists, and that means that everything on the stick is selected. Another way would be just to manually select it, or I could just go about it with a random selection, but we take everything on it because this won't take very long, as you can see. This is all real time, folks. I'm not going to interfere in it in any way. And the DJ conversion utility is done, and you could see that it already started Traktor and it started Serato because those were target conversion apps. And what has happened in Traktor is analyze these first, is created. That is the playlist with all the tracks that were newly introduced to the collection. Just select all tracks in it and say analyze, and it will analyze all tracks. We have to do the same thing in Serato. And this analyzation, by the way, folks, is required because you want to have that waveform on your screen ready to go. And in case of Traktor, for instance, the volume levels are analyzed as well, which is just convenient. And like I said, we have to do the same within Serato. But as you can see, there were no crates created. The DJ conversion utility does not create any crates. It uses the iTunes integration. And as you see here, analyze these in Serato first is under the iTunes tab. Select all the tracks and just drag them to analyze files. And that will be running as well. So both Traktor as well as Serato are analyzing as we speak. Serato is true, and that means I quit Serato for now, because then I'm going to show you the real trick. And Traktor is done as well, so I can quit that too. Now, on this stick, all of a sudden there is a Serato folder created that contains the basic collection contained on this stick. Now, we run the DJ conversion utility, and it produced a Traktor DDCU NML inside the ATDR production team folder, inside the documents folder. I put that one on the USB because that is actually the part you want to import in your friend's Traktor collection if you want to use this CDG on a foreign Traktor collection. Another thing you want to have is the iTunes XML. And the iTunes XML is created within the music folder, the iTunes folder, and there you got the iTunes Music Library XML. Just put it on the USB. And now things are going to get a little bit geeky, so bear with me. I put this to the side, and I'm going to reset both my Traktor and my iTunes collection. Now first let me show you what we've got. If I open iTunes, you see I've got an entirely different collection from what it used to be. There it starts with the Quack Demo containment folder. I quit iTunes, I open the Music iTunes folder. And in there is this iTunes Music Library XML. I'm going to replace that with the one from the USB. And remember, that is the one directly after the conversion copied to the USB. Now, there is no harm in replacing this XML, because the moment I start up iTunes and I quit it or I change something in iTunes, it is reproduced automatically by iTunes. The iTunes Music Library XML is only an export transmission. It doesn't import. There is nothing there that iTunes is using, so it's completely safe to overwrite it with another XML. Because when I start up iTunes, it's going to be replaced by the actual collection XML. So that's why I did that. Then if I fire up Traktor, you see there is a different collection there as well. And what I want to do is first have the information from that collection NML, which was created by DDCU inside. Click on the import, right click on it, say import playlist, and navigate to the USB and pick the Traktor DDCU NML right there. Use the information from the file and it will prompt you for a playlist name. But we are not going to hang out in the playlist part of Traktor. No, we are going to the iTunes part of Traktor. And there you see the DG conversion utility folder from Rekordbox, the Rekordbox play, the imported playlists. And here we go with actually the stuff that was just converted.
Hey, yo, listen what I got your head.
As you can see, this is coming from a Rekordbox CDG USB prepared drive, folks. So that's how you enable it for Traktor inside a foreign collection. You can do exactly the same in Serato. If I go to Serato and I go to the DJ conversion utility part, the Rekordbox part, this is taken from the iTunes XML, which I replaced inside the music library, remember? And there we go again to the acapellas, why not? And we take that same 50 cents one, and there you go. So forget about crates, use the iTunes part, which was created by the DJ Converse utility, and you're good to go. So this stick already works right now out of the box in both Traktor as well as Serato, as well as in a Pioneer CDG. But the next phase is to use it on a Denon Prime player. And I hear you think, hey Mixmaster G, why do you need to convert a CDG USB to a Denon Prime player, because these things can already read CDG USB sticks? Well, they do, but not completely. There are some important features left out. First of all, the cues and loops stored in the memory bank are not converted by the player. Only the hot cues and hot loops are converted. So you might miss out on some very important cues. But even more important, the BPM value that you had set in Rekordbox and with the acapellas you see me use, that is really very important, is not converted by the player. However, the procedure I'm going to show you using the Denon conversion utility will take the BPM from the Rekordbox collection, which is used on the CDG, and use it as well on the Denon Prime players. Another benefit is that your entire stick is all analyzed and ready to run after this procedure, which means no wait times for the players to finish analyzation when a track is being loaded. And I will show you that all in the players right beside me. So with no further ado, let's fire up the Denon conversion utility. And there we get all kinds of famous messages from Mojave again. We tell it to use the XML that is stored on the stick. There we are. And everything is basically set correctly. We can let it run. We want to take everything in on the stick.
The Denon conversion utility will continue after you have closed this alert box. My voice will guide you.
I know, folks, this is the most confusing part of the whole procedure. What will happen is,
analyze all tracks in the crate named, analyze these tracks first. This crate could be found under the Denon conversion utility crate.
And we do as the voice said. First, I create an empty crate. You will see in a moment why. Then I go to the Denon conversion utility crate, and underneath there is the analyze these tracks first crate. Let me put that to the side. I select all tracks in there. I right click on it and say re-import the track information that will be running right here.
Wait until all tracks are analyzed and then quit engine prime.
Then concurrently I say analyze tracks, and you can see that the analyzation is running right here. It's counting down already as we speak. While this is all running, I press command Q, or I quit engine prime, but I don't click the yes button. I switch this to quit engine prime when complete. At this stage, everything is on automatic. I don't need to do anything more, but it's important that the tracks are analyzed before the actual conversion is going to happen, because otherwise the converted information is overwritten by the analyzed information, and that's not what you want. So analyzation has to be done first, and after that the conversion will take place. Sit back a little bit, I will going to show you the end results in just a few. Analyzation is done and everything is converted. The beauty of the Engine Prime ecosystem is that the disk that you plug into the player is actually the same disk as you use as your collection disk. So this ATGR demo disk, if I fire up Engine Prime, it will show me how this looks like on the player. Let me show that. You will see in a moment exactly this same structure on the player. So if you don't have a Prime 4, if you don't have an SC5000 series player, but you want to mess around a little bit with this stuff and see that indeed this conversion works as I say it works, you can take the Engine Prime from the Denon DJ site. It's free to download and free to use. You can get a copy of the Denon Converse utility and you can see for yourself that this will indeed give you what you need, an exact reproduction of a CDG USB on the Prime player. I'm going to take the USB out and then move to the back to the Prime players and insert the CDG USB. One thing you will notice, the Prime player will prompt me if I want to convert the record box collection. It is important that you press no at that stage, because you don't want to use the existing collection, you want to use the converted collection. And if you press no, it will default to the Engine Prime library, which is what we will. After this, I will show you the results of a conversion from the player in the acapella list from exactly this stick. If you look at my comment field, you see that I've got a key and a comment right there. And you can see that right now these are all the same, because like I said, the BPM values are converted from Rekordbox. You will notice the difference when I do this by the player and then convert it using the player's built-in conversion analyzed in Engine Prime and show you the results. Let me make a screen cut of this.
Fab 5 Freddy told me everybody's fly, blushes fast. Well, now you see what you want to be. Back to, back to.
Now you did see me take the USB out. What I did is I cleared the Engine Prime library so the new one could be created using the built-in conversion capabilities of the player. And let me show you what's happening, because this is rather shocking if you see it for the first time. We need to go to the playlists part, because that's why Denon likes to store its stuff. And there we've got everything right here. And it looks like everything is just fine, right? You see there, it looks all about right. But looks can be deceiving, because this stuff has not been analyzed yet, because you can tell the grid is not there. I select them all and just let them analyze. And then all of a sudden, please watch the BPM values of certain tracks right there. These can shockingly different. You see the focus track went from a 100 BPM track to an 80 BPM track. You see the rapture track is just fine. You see the stressed out by 21 pilots is completely off. So there are quite some tracks which are shockingly different from what they are supposed to be. And of course, it's very, very hard to analyze a cappellas. And most of these a cappellas were manually beat gridded in Rekordbox, or actually in Traktor, and then converted to Rekordbox in my case. But it's important to remain that BPM value, especially for those hard to BPM, hard to grid tracks. And that's why I like to use my own tools to do the conversion, because let me put next to it the conversion from the Denon conversion utility, the screen cut I made, remember? And there you can see, find the differences. To the right, this is all Denon conversion utility converted, and to the left, this is all converted or converted by the player, and then Engine Prime analyzed, which is the same analyzation as inside the player. That was all I want to tell you about and show you. Mixmaster G is signing off.